Beltrani, and she's going to show us some about her programs having to do with gravity and balance and amusement park physics.
Yay! How's everybody? Today, I am Mrs. Beltrani. I'm the owner, bottle washer, cooker pans on science. I've been teaching science programs in schools and libraries for really longer than I've been kids. At least 10 years, that's all I'm going to say. If you need references, librarians, I have to kind of hopefully some of them are in the room. Hi! There they are.
Yay!
So your reading classification this summer is, what is it now? It's Ready, Set, Read. Read. Ready, Set, Read. Well, I changed that a little bit, and I figured, well, Ready, Set, Move would work out as well, particularly this is the summer, when the children are home from school. So in order to move well, there are some people who are naturally capable with regard to sports and dance and balance and all of that stuff, and those people have a natural sense of their center of gravity. So one of the programs which I'll tell you about today is called Balance and Gravity. And the program teaches the children from start to finish how important it is to understand where center of mass is and how that helps us function well or move easily throughout the day. And most of my programs have the make and take at the end of it that's tied into the theme of the program, most of them. I have a forensic archaeology program, it's human bone. I can't give those away. So I'm always afraid I'm going to be pulled over and I'll have bones in the car. So balance and gravity explains how gravity pulls from center mass. And I do, it's a takeoff on good old David Letterman. You know, human body tricks. And I hold the children up in groups and have them work through a series of physical motions that prevents them from shifting their center of gravity, and then one that allows them so that they're able actually to feel the difference when they're able to shift their center of gravity and move. And a very good example is putting, Pat, did you want to do it? Oh, my goodness. And you thought you were going to stand there. Oh, okay, your timing won't work. Okay, whoops. Oh, my goodness, things are falling apart. So, for example, come on over here. Oh, you're nice and tall. So I said, Patty, go up on your toes. Now turn around and put your toes against the wall. Okay, that was good. And put your heels down. Yeah, toes against the wall. Now stand up on your toes. Okay? It's very, very good today. Give her a hand. It's very, very difficult to do because the wall prevents us from shifting our center of gravity forward. So that's what allows us to balance. So there are a series of different examples like that. Then we work with car slams. Kids love car slams and how the different humps, yes, affects how gravity pulls and how gravity works on an object falling down. And they have to balance better on their finger, good time. And also they're moving with that. And then at the end they make a balance toy. This is what they get to take home. And they have to shift the center of gravity to allow this to stand up on their fingers. So this is balancing gravity. It's a fun program, and it does get them up and moving. Another program that works very, very, very well for the summer is amusement park physics, because there are fairs all over Suffolk County, and it explains, again, the physics of motion. One of the things I always try to make a point of, regardless of the program I'm presenting, is that there's science in everything we do, including amusement park rides. So that one is fun because I have a station. I usually set my classes up in stations so that the class gets to move through each station and handle everything that I have for that program. One of the stations is, it looks like bumper cars. Everybody loves bumper cars. And what happens when you increase the mass on one or other of the bumper cars, how it changes the motion and the acceleration of that object. And the finale for that class is tubing and design rolling, which is a lot of fun. And again, it's all science, it's all physics. So how would you manipulate this tubing to get a marble from the top around, no matter what you want to do, curves and loops and all that other out to the end. So that one is a lot of fun. And I don't necessarily have anything. Oh, well, this also too. This is for balancing gravity. So
gravity's pulling from its center. This is one of the stations in balance and gravity, and it's a lot of fun. So that's that program, and then again, they get the make and take for that one. Another program, Amusement Park Physics. I am not one of those big fancy science people that has been exploding and stuff like that. I really do teach like science. That's what I do. And it also helps to bring back the idea that science is everywhere we look. So in Amusement Park Physics, I explain why you have to be buckled in on a ride, why you have to wear a seatbelt while you're in the car, why you cannot stand up in a moving bus. I would suggest this. So I use, very simply, duck in a truck. That's it. That's all I need. And so here's Doug moving along, and I explain the science of inertia. We do a lot of Newton speaking. This is Newton's cradle. So I explain a little bit about energy, how energy is transferred through objects, how you can multiply that. I dealt with 2 will go on the other side. How this will stop on its own eventually because of friction. The energy is changing heat and sound, so that will stop. And the same thing here. So here's Doug riding along having a grand all day. So delighted it didn't snow. Okay, and here comes a bump in the road. Duck is not buckled in. And there goes Duck.
Why?
Because moving in a state of inertia, moving in this direction, there's nothing to prevent. It's science. People keep moving in that direction unless the force stops. Doing that, that forces your seatbelt. That forces the buckle on any ride in an amusement park. So I use that, and they do, believe it or not, they love Duck in a truck better than an explosion. All right, kind of. So those are the 2 programs that really work very, very, very well for the summer. My programs run between 55 and 60 minutes, depending on how many children, how many patients you have signed up. I cap my classes out at 25 because I do have a minimum of 4 stations per program. And I find that if it's more than 25 children, they all cannot participate equally, and I'm not all about that. All of my programs I have written, they're all mine. So if you have a class that may have a different take on things, or even if you know the YA or the Gershwin librarian, all of these programs can be kicked up a notch for the older children as well. If you have, and Laurie's here, so I can say this, I will get a call occasionally from Laurie and say, you know, do you have a program about fill in the blank? So if you have patrons coming up to you that have questions or if you have a program about this, if I can, I'll write your program. No worries. And a lot of my programs, in fact, the one I'm going to mention for the fall, I know you're thinking summer. Oh, I'm thinking summer. But for the fall, this program will come very, very, very quickly. It's gruesome Halloween science, and that's nice to do. Lori. Ooh, I know. It's fabulous. So there are a ton of things that are done for this program. It's a chemistry-based program. Again, it's like everything we do. Thank you. And one of the things that I do, one of the things the kids love is, so we have 2 liquids, and I explain how a chemical reaction takes place, one liquid into the other. They get to keep all of this. They walk out with their goodie bags and stuff. And then we shake this. I also have goldenrod paper, where they can write a gruesome message that turns blood red. I'll show you that as soon as I'm shaking this. Yay! So this is part of the gruesome Halloween program, and it's also, again, it's all chemistry, and very quickly, I will show you the basic solution. Right, so it's clear water, but it hits the goldenrod paper and turns a bright blood red, which is oodles of fun, because they can write messages in blood, or they can put your handprints on, looks like a crime scene. All good. Okay, another program that I really do love for the science of the summer, rather, is my Reach for the Stars program. I have a portable planetarium. I don't have a dome, so it helps if I have a fairly unbroken ceiling, a dark room. This may not work for the really itty-bitty because the room is dark, but your parents can join it. They want the room. And again, this goes with the reading. Absolutely, there are a ton of books that are available about the stories, the constellation stories. And they're fascinating, fun. Some of them are a little scary.
stories about constellations, how they're named, why they're named the way they are, and why they have the shape that they do. And at the end, they get a star map for the Northern Hemisphere, which is where we are, and the stars that are in the sky that month. So if you book this in June, they'll get a different star map than the class will in August or September. So there are a lot of programs that you can choose for, thank you, for the summer. And also, please do be mindful of the fall. That gruesome Halloween science program will be very, very, very quickly. So I think I've said it. Oh, if you have any problems, you call me. That's it. I'm in. I'm in on science. You can call me. I'm with the president and all of that stuff. It's my pleasure. I love working with you guys. You're all awesome. Are there any questions or comments that you might have? Programs start at $200, depending on the program. That goes up if there is a material fee. Halloween science is a bit more expensive because the children walk out with four or five different things. And here's the blood red dot. I wasn't telling you the story. So it's a lot of fun. And please do consider, you know, giving hands-on science a call. I'm available on weekends. Whenever you need me, I will work with you. Don't worry. And I think our reference is there right there.